liga ng bawat Pilipino sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. Ang bawat laban ay nakakakaba dahil sa husay ng bawat isa. Sigawan ay umayanig kapag nag-three points na. Bawat bayay di patatalo, buong barangay ay suportado. Kahit ano ang mangyari, sama-sama tayo. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. MPBL na, MPBL na. Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. MPBL na. Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao.
Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League. Ang bawat bayan ay sumasaya kapag may labay nagkakaisa. Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, basketball na. Ang bawat labay pinaghahandaan, kaya yumayanig ang bakbakan. Todo suporta ang lahat sa kanya-kanyang kubunan. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, MPBL na, MPBL na. Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. Ay nakakakaba dahil sa husay ng bawat isa. Sigawan ay umayanig kapag nag-three points na. Bawat bayay di patatalo, buong barangay ay suportado. Kahit ano ang mangyari, sama-sama tayo. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, MPBL na, MPBL na. Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League.
saya kapag may labay nagkakaisa. Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, basketball na. Ang bawat labay pinaghahandaan, kaya yung mayanig ang bakbakan. Todo suporta ang lahat sa kanya-kanyang kuponan. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, MPBL na! MPBL na! Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. MPBL na! Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. Ang bawat laban ay nakakakaba dahil sa husay ng bawat isa. Sigawan na yumayanig kapag nag-three points na. Bawat bayay di patatalo, buong barangay ay suportado. Kahit ano ang mangyari, sama-sama tayo. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, MPBL na! MPBL na! Yan ang liga ng bawat Pilipino, sa Luzon, sa Visayas, sa Mindanao. Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League. Ang bawat bayan ay sumasaya kapag may labay nagkakaisa. Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, basketball na. Ang bawat labay pinaghahandaan, kaya yumayanig ang bakbakan. Todo suporta ang lahat sa kanya-kanyang kuponan. Basketball na muna tayo, iwasan na ang mga bisyo. Sports ang laging iisipin, sa droga ay huwag paalipin. Buong bansa'y magsama-sama. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, MPBL na!
Ito ang MPBL, ang liga ng bawat Pilipino. And we welcome you back to the Paco Arena in Manila for tonight's main game. Manila SV Batang Sampaloc SGA will be testing the mettle of the unbeaten Bataan Risers led by Rafi Octubre, who was the best player the last time out. Rafi will be a marked man against Manila, which will be parading the likes of veterans like Carl Brian Cruz, Rabah Aluseni, and Pau Havilona. Our match for tonight, it's the Bataan Risers versus the Manila SV Batang Sampaloc SGA. Magandang gabi mga kaliga. We'd like to welcome you back to our coverage dito sa Paco Arena. Si Dav Tupas, sama si Christian Luanzon, and of course, Mika Abisamis from courtside. A lot of questions have been posed to this Manila team, Coach Christian. How strong are they? Are they contenders this season?
Well, that remains yet to be seen, even after getting their first win against Bulacan, because alam naman natin, the buzz about Manila has yet to arrive, and that's a big seven-footer in Greg Slaughter, who, from what I know, is arriving next month. So that remains yet to be seen. But if he arrives, and as we expect him to be in form coming from, you know, coming from the Japan, so condition dapat yan, and coming in the mix of, you know, with teammates like Rabah Aluseni, Carl Brian Cruz, Pau Havelona, and the others, well, they will certainly be a contender.
Oh, no. And Bataan naman is coming in on a two-game winning streak. Tinalo nila ang Bacolod sa Valenzuela. It was an 86-74 win this season. And Rafi Octubre, as we mentioned, doing most of the damage in that ball game. And that's two wins in a row for Bataan. They won on their home floor against Sarangani and then followed it up with a win over Bacolod.
Well, I think what's more impressive about the win, even though this ended up in the final score of leading by double figures, is Bataan showed their depth. And they played 15 players, and out of the 15, 13 scored. Each player played at least 3 or 4 minutes. And maganda pa rito, no, this was a close game except nung huli na lang. So this was not a throwaway game wherein they were leading at pinasok yung mga ibang players. They showed depth. Rafi Octubre led all scorers off the bench with 15 points. Kaya 51-40 yung naging advantage ng bench.
Yeah, 3-point shooting also going the way of the Risers. Pag-usapan naman natin ang sa kabilang banda, Manila. They won against Bulacan last Saturday in Bataan, 75-70. Carl Brian Cruz with a strong performance, and kagagaling to sa patalo against Paranaque.
Right.
Now, they started out the season really flat, but here they are. They come back and beat Bulacan.
Even in this game, even though it ended up as a W, I thought they were flat as well, except for the third quarter. Able to create separation, and you'll see the numbers in a little bit right here. The big part here to me was the passing department. The assist, 25-14. Their point guards were outstanding. Paulo Havelona and Lorenzo Navarro, you know, former NU standout, former La Salle and San Sebastian standout in Navarro, both had 14 assists and only 2 turnovers combined. So that was huge for them to escape Bulacan, who just came off a loss, a 30-point loss in tonight's game, in the previous game.
A strong response from Manila. Can they sustain that winning streak, or will Bataan get one on the road? Let's go to Richard Tampos for the starting lineup.
MPTV Satellite Channel 53 and on Filipinas Live App. The 2024 Buenas Manny Pacquiao's MPBL Season 6 presented by Extreme. Here are the starters. Let's begin with the one Bataan Risers, Kamaya Coast. Center number 45, Mitchell Minus. Forward number 39, Jamil Gabawan. Starting at guard number 22, Yves Sason. At forward number 14, Alex Ramos. Point guard number 1, Roby Darang. While Bataan Risers Kamaya Coast head coach is Goody Ilagan, with Rene Baina. His assistants are Brian Gorospe, Prince Cruz, Louis Cortina, Ernie Laurel, and Marvin Molines. Assistant team manager Shai Ibangilista, LGU coordinator Erwin Oximoso, team manager attorney Gary Palmero, team owner is Luis Valenzuela.
And now, the starting five for your Manila SV Batang Sampaloc SGA. Starting at forward number 1, DJ Mitchell. Point guard number 11, Pau Havelona. power forward number 17, Carl Brian Cruz. Starting at guard number 18, Francis Escandor. And at center number 28, your very own from Tondo, Manila, Sean Umali. Manila SP Batang Sampaloc SGA is led by Gabby Severino. His assistants are Ricky Dandan, Ren Noriega, and Max Dayandante.
Starting five of the game is brought to you by Buenas. The visitors have Robbie Darang, Eves Sasso, and Mitchell Maynes, Jamil Gabawan, and Alex Ramos. For Manila, it's Pau Havilona, Francis Escandor, Sean O'Malley, Carl Brian Cruz, and DJ Mitchell. Ball is up and we are underway. Bataan in white, Manila in blue. Here we go. Robbie Darang at the controls. Minus Sazon for three. Carl Brian Cruz secures the rebound. Mitchell looking to push the pace.
That's going to be an interesting matchup, though. Sazon coming off the screen. Defending him was Escandor, basically a 3-and-D guy for La Salle.
Babilona, good catch underneath, and he scores on the reverse.
Pau Havilona, a veteran and a guy who could pretty much do everything. He's been in different roles in different teams. He's been in a role wherein he's been the primary scorer, coming off the bench, now the lead point guard for this supposed to be stacked Manila team.
Can play alongside Lorenzo Navarro as well.
No, he's a guy who can fit anywhere. Pau Havilona. Remember, he used to be dubbed as a Ravenna, a Kiefer Ravenna stopper nung college days niya.
Yeah. Won the championship with NU.
He did, yeah. As Mitchell, that historic championship.
Mitchell Maynes scores and puts Bataan on the board. Sean O'Malley forces his way in. That's a turnover.
I'm trying to bulldoze his way here as Maynes winning that matchup on that play, forcing the turnover for Sean O'Malley, the former Blazer.
No.
Torp still.
Incoming.
Still.
Incoming.
Incoming. Sorry.
Baka magtampo si Charles Chu sa'yo.
Mali, mali.
Ives Sazo knocks down that long two. They're, hindi sila ganun kadami, pero ang ingay ng fans ng Bataan dito. Ah.
It's always been like that. But imagine, for those who haven't seen a Bataan game live or on TV, imagine their home court. Pero laging may ano yan, ever since... May pinapadala, may papas pa yan eh.
Oo.
Para sa fans, ha?
Oo.
So yung support ng LGU, makikita mo nandun talaga.
Havilona draws the foul on Robbie Darang. He'll go to the line for two free throws. Our referees for this matchup, Jojo Belnas, Manuel Binondo, and Jonathan Kanda.
Well, this is something that Paolo Havilona can take advantage, at least the first part of this game. Certainly has the upper hand against a younger, less experienced Robbie Darang, who's improved a lot.
Yeah.
You know, you could say he had a breakout season from last year. You know, did not start maybe until midway through the season.
Sazon is fouled on the way to the basket. There's a big collision there. I think that was a foul on Escandor. And it was a big collision because Sean O'Malley was involved.
Actually, vertical lang si Sean O'Malley. Eh.
Yung tulak galing kay
Escandor.
Escandor. It didn't look good because yung bagsak.
Yung bagsak.
Well, one interesting sideline here is that Coach Ricky Dandan, who coached Bataan last season, now with Manila.
Excuse me, yeah.
Helping out Coach Gabby Severino.
Assistant coach, rather, yeah.
That's Coach Ricky right there. 6-4 ang ating score ngayon. Cruz, that is off. Carl Brian Cruz, great D galing kay Robbie Darang, forcing that turnover.
Take a look at head coach, Coach Gabby Severino.
Steal by Mitchell. Recovers. Mitchell. Kyle Brian Cruz for three. That's a foul on Minus.
That's a close call. From our angle, I thought the official was going to call an offensive foul. That a la Reggie Miller kick after the shot. And that's what Minus is contesting. Nonetheless, Kyle Brian Cruz now at the line. Look at this one. Kick up to the corner. Watch the right leg. Right there. See, I thought that's an offensive foul. So Manila gets away with that one.
Brian Cruz is emerging as the go-to guy for this Manila team.
So we mentioned in the pregame that they made their run, the 24-14 third quarter in the last game. And a big part of that was led by Carl Brian Cruz, who had 17 points in the game, 6 in that quarter. That's a push from Brian. Former FEU Tamaraw. A champion as well.
Yeah.
Nasa bayan nila po ko ito, no? Part of that Gilas team.
Darang. Nabantay ni Havilona. Robbie, dire-direcho. Palpalang inabot kay Carl Brian Cruz.
Nice
Mitchell
pass.
Is on his way to get the 2 points.
Beautiful lead pass from Havilona. Mitchell showing the hops, finishing at the tip of the rim.
O'Malley with a rebound. Manila looking to push. Mitchell. We go down low to Sean O'Malley. Against Ramos. O'Malley. Masyado malakas ang pasa kay Escandor. Darang. Bounce pass to Ramos. Gabawan on the putback. No.
A wasted opportunity that time. Two chances at the rim on the break with the advantage. Bataan fails to convert.
There's O'Malley again. Gets into the lane. Wala pa rin. Darang. Gabawa now with Sazon.
He's looking to shoot.
Sazon. No good. Minus. With the rebound.
Nice move.
What a move. Minus! With a finger roll. Ganda naman nun, Coach Christian.
Yeah, he just caught Mitchell flat-footed after that in-and-out move going to his right. Binitbit pa, pinakita ang bola. Tinapos sa ring. Carl Brian Cruz naman, top of the key, 3.
11-8, halfway tayo na dito sa ating first quarter. Escandor could not complete the steal. Sazon fires short.
Excellent individual defense by Escandor, twice covering the back door and then challenging and blocking the shot of Ives Sazon, a prolific scorer.
Escandor for three. No. Alex Ramos with the rebound. Here comes Robbie Darang. Darang to Sazon. Yes! And we are tied.
And that's the difference. When you get a stop and you get cross-matched, on the other end. Escandor was not on Yves Sazon. And Sazon takes advantage. Escandor going strong to his left and finishes at the rim.
Francis Escandor, UAAP champion.
Thank you for the reminder.
Ah, sorry. Kayo ba tinalo? Joke lang. Darang. Oh, what a move. Robbie Darang. Using that crossover and finishing with his right.
Offhand. For the left-handed Robbie Darang.
O'Malley gets a running start, and he finishes.
Funny how you say that, no? The irony. O'Malley with the running start. Nice pass.
A lot of jogging start. They go down low to Minus. Easy, too.
Could have been the three-point play, too. O'Malley on the floor.
I think itong, you know, Batangas started well this season. Alam ko maaga nagsimulang mag-prepare itong Batangas.
I believe so, too. Coach Rene Baina, former coach and a colleague of mine. The former coach back in the PBL days, a decade ago, more than a decade ago. Asa under din yan kay Coach Gold. Won championships with the NU Bullpups. Now the head coach of Bataan. Nakatira yan sa Bataan. Oh, on the way.
Of course, the team owner and actually yung coach nila is team owner Goody Ilagan. You know, ang nakalista dito. Rabah Al-Husseini is fouled. Let's go to Mika Abisamis.
The past two games, I asked the coaching staff what they have discovered about their team, their lineup, talking about Manila. And they said, well, we obviously have depth, but we need to be more cohesive. Transition is the priority for this game, especially with one of their coaches, Ricky Dandan, is familiar with the boys of Bataan. As you mentioned, he was able to help in terms of making the team aware of the running game of Bataan. They are so happy so far with the performances of CBC and DJ Mitchell, but are still looking for more from Rabah Al-Husseini while waiting for Greg Slaughter, who is, by the way, coming in June. Sidelf Coach Chris.
Thank you so much, Mika. So, confirmation, June ang dating niya.
One month late yung sinabi ko.
June ang dating niya, Greg Slaughter. Oh, what a tandem it would be. Rabah Al-Husseini and Greg Slaughter. Two former UAAP MVPs.
Right. Former Ateneo Blue Eagles.
Castro, that's a difficult shot. Navarro leading the break. Finds John Hamon for the baseline jumper.
Ito yung sinasabi in relation to Mika's report, the depth of Manila. John Hamon, a scorer, alam naman natin kapasidad niya, lalo na nung panahon niya sa Pasay. They have Didat Hanapi who gave up his playing years as a Falcon. Lorenzo Navarro as a former San Sebastian point guard. They have young legs, they have depth, they have Batalier. If this team could come together, they can be really not only dangerous but a contender, especially with Greg Snowder coming in. And Hanapi, welcome.
Now, Didat Hanapi, what a pickup para sa Manila. Ito yung team. You know, with all the veteran talent that they have, they need a young gun like Didat.
Kailangan nila yung mga ganito eh. And sometimes, the young guns can win you a quarter or two and eventually win you a game or slash games. And in a long season of 28 games, sometimes magkakaroon ng off night yung mga inaasahan mo, yung mga star players mo.
So Manila will have possession. Ira Batalier. I'm excited for the RV Bringas Sean O'Malley matchup.
Okay, alang off the bench si RV Bringas, but at some point, alam mo nga magkakabanggaan yan, dalawang yan sa loob.
Well, I stand corrected. Si Greg Slaughter pala hindi nag-MVP. So, champion lang.
Champion. Pero nung time niya, si Kiefer. Nagkasabay sila at si Kiefer ang nag-champion. Nag-MVP.
free throw is brought to you by Extreme Appliances, ang subok at kompletong appliance brand ng Pilipinas. Yes. Raba Al-Husseini sinks the free throw. Seems to be in really good shape, ito si Raba.
Moving well.
Oh.
Also. Always, has always had the nice touch. For a big guy. With a face-up jumper on the post. Used to be lethal.
Oh.
That's
a foul on Navarro.
That's a foul. No. Trying to contest his bataan for continuation. Nonetheless, it will be a foul, pero inbound play lang.
They're checking if he still...
It looks to be continuation. Pa-pick up na yung ball eh.
Oo, kung hindi na nag-dribble, then that's continuation. He will get continuation, yes.
See? I mean, my dad in the States, that's what he does during his weekends. He's a referee. So he gives you a few pointers.
Shout out to Christian's dad for
Ricardo
for that input. Jeff Santos at the line. So subukan talaga ng depth dito because an entirely different unit is on the floor.
Platoon substitution tong dalawang to nung a minute ago in this game.
It's a poor foul to give up as well.
Penalty na eh.
Sa backcourt pa eh. Enzo Navarro at the line. Had a really good season with Iloilo last year. Two for two. Para kay Renzo Navarro, pressure here. Ron Lastimosa. They go to Rafi Octubre. Yes, Batalier, James Castro. Octubre will take the three. No. It's a good challenge there by Manila. Parang aware sila dito sa kakayahan ni Rafi Octubre.
Yeah, scouted, no? The execution also on the ball screen. Not so much separation between the ball handler and Octubre. And anytime na hindi ka nakakapag-separate sa depensa, it's an easier task for the defenders to recover.
Ira Batalier at the line. Short on the first. He's been with Manila for quite some time now. Naglaro din yan earlier in the 2022 season, actually. So bola mananatili sa Manila. 0 for 2 si Batalier. Navarro to inbound. They go to Hamon. Navarro. Makes his move. The kick out. Hanapi for 3. Yes! Great pass kay Renzo Navarro.
What a beautiful breakdown move by Navarro. Attack. The lane drive to his right, countered with the behind the back, and a perfect timed kick out. Pasarap pa lang yung depensa, pinasan eh. Kaya hindi na naka-recover yung tao ni Hanapi. Look at this one. Pagkasara, bigay.
Three-point shot of the game is brought to you by Extreme One-Stop Shop Appliances.
You know, passes like that, they can really make a huge difference sa recipient.
Santos, that's short. And a great defensive sequence para sa Manila to close out this first quarter. Strong start para sa Manila SB. Batang Sampaloc SGA, they take a double-digit lead by the efforts of Mitchell Maynes or Bataan. So far, walang sagot ang Bataan sa second unit nitong Manila. 28-17, end of the first quarter scores brought to you by GameX. Papanood nyo ang Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League on MPTV Channel 98 on Signal. Also on Pilipinas Live and also on Facebook and on YouTube. Joe Ramos in attendance. Rudy Destrito as well, our security head, and Emer Oreta. Bola ng Bataan to start the second quarter.
Well, we talked about depth for both teams, and obviously that category won by Manila after 10 minutes of play. All 10 players have scored already for Manila. So yung first group at second group nila, nakapuntos na.
There's a foul on Chris Torado. Medyo hirap siya sa matchup na yun. With Ira Batalier. Navarro. Nice pass. Rabba Al-Husseini with a finish.
Yeah, just a miscommunication on the ball screen defense. They were squeezing the ball screen, which means wala dapat chance mag-roll yung roller. But instead, the big guy was forced to challenge the shot, and Al-Husseini was wide open underneath. Beautiful dump by Navarro.
Maynes.
Nice.
Wow, a variety of moves. Galing kay Mitchell Maynes. He really has that breakdown dribble. Dalawang beses na ginawa sa larong to. Navarro.
Able to create contact and force a foul on that reject ball screen. Look at this one. Squeeze on the ball screen and then the last minute decision to pass the ball.
Play of the game is brought to you by Buenas. And what about this one? Mitchell Maynes in his bag. Gets the layup to drop. Al-Husseini well defended by Aquino.
He's trying to fish for a foul. A good job by Aquino. Of just putting his hands up.
Oh, Chris Torado. Don't forget about me.
One of your favorites. You have been always outspoken about this.
Oh, what about this move, Christian?
Tama, no? Umatake pa siya dun sa kung nasan yung kakampi niya, si Aquino at si Al-Husseini. Masikip, pero walang problema para sa kanya. Ang ganda ng finish niya, no? Sa board, may kasama pang foul.
Let's go to Mika.
According to Coach Goody Ilagan, he likes the results so far of the team, but still a lot to fix internally. For this game specifically, for teams that have very nice setups backed up by supportive management, it's always a good game to watch. Sabi nga ni Coach Rene Baena, I live for games like this one. Napansin daw niya ang resiliency ng risers in their last two wins, which speaks of good conditioning by everybody. Malakas o mahina daw sila sa kalaban, importante yung nakakasabay hanggang dulo. Agree, CNC?
Thank you, Mika. I have to agree. Kasi nakita ko na yung, you know, first two games nila. You can never count them out. Every time there's a haymaker, you know, in boxing terms pa.
Right.
May balik eh.
Right.
And then, Well, they're trying to stay in the thick of the fight here.
Tarado has been a difference maker on both ends. Oh, their offense getting into a rhythm. That time, the tap from behind, Avellona, and they were challenged this call. No, hindi na kailangan ng challenge. Kasi overturned by another official who probably had a better angle. I was about to say, they need stops. Kasi naka-convert sila on the other end. They get the stop. Can they convert on this possession?
They go to Sazon.
Nice.
Gabawan. Underneath, Torado is there. Block. Minus.
Shot clock.
Nice pass to Sazon for three. Yes, sir. What a look.
That's something you don't do. Give a sharpshooter like Sazon a look. And a poor decision by Hamon. Not choosing the lesser evil. Iniwanan niya si Sazon.
Ratapek Didat. Again, no. Gabawan with a rebound. Momentum for Bataan. Here's Gabawan to Sazon. One dribble pull-up. Too strong. Rebound ni Hanapi. Quickly to Cruz. Cruz will lay it in. 7 points for Carl Brian Cruz. Manila extends the lead back to 9 points. We have a timeout. 35-26, 6:46 remaining in the first half. Back inside the Paco Arena for this matchup between Bataan and Manila. Bataan still unbeaten so far this season. Dalawang panalo na. And Manila naman looking to go back-to-back wins. Playing their first home game of the season. Let's watch this fast break of the game brought to you by New Star Max. Win to the max. Easy finish para kay Carl Brian Cruz. Robby Darang, binabantay ni Pau Havilona. Mitchell Minus. 8D by Mitchell. Quite risky that pass. 10 seconds of shot clock dito ng Bataan. Gabawan. Trying to find Minus. Gets it on the second serving. Meron na siyang 10 puntos. First Bataan player in double figures, Mitchell Minus. Avellona to Mitchell. Three, no. And nahayaan na lang ni Jamil Gabawan. And Dante Baguio coming in.
So after that timeout, Bataan able to score, getting a stop slowly but surely. Yeah, trimming this lead and a chance once again to do so.
Ito simula nung report ni Mika eh.
yun eh.
Oh. Mitchell Minus. Minus. Aquino with a jumper. Yes, sir. Ray Aquino did not play in the previous game. Activated para sa larong to. Siguro dahil maraming big man na kalaban. Natapek ang bola. Minus. He'll go all the way. He will not get the bucket. Pero pupunta siya sa linya for 2 free throws.
And that's the beauty of the game, especially if it starts on the defensive end. You get a stop, you get a rebound, and then you give the ball to a guy like Minus who could go all the way. Sayang na opportunity for the three-point play, but nonetheless, an opportunity for them to trim this lead down into single, a single possession.
11 points para kay Mitchell Minus. What a pickup para sa Bataan. He had limited time. No, he won the title with Pampanga, but did not really play that, you know, that much in that championship run.
Loaded naman kasi yung roster na yun, obviously, led by Baltasar, Encho Serrano.
So, Sazon pinahinga muna, John Formento in the game. First time ni John sa larong to. Pao Javelona uses the O'Malley pick. Javelona, the kick out. Carl Brian Cruz for three.
And that's something that for sure Bataan, the coaches will talk about how they defend the ball screens, because that was a breakdown that led a breakdown for Paolo Javelona and a pass to the wide open corner on the other side.
Minus to Aquino, fires, yes again. Rey Aquino, 4 points.
What a wonderful feeling when you make back-to-back baskets. Iniiwan mo na yung follow-through mo sa pangalawa.
Avellona for three. That's good. 41 to 34.
Nice shot, but a beautiful read by Avellona. Defense goes under. Cheats him on the ball screen. Makes the defense pay.
Meron na 7 points si Pau. Baguio. Labas muna kay Minus. Escandor na nakabantay. Minus. The runner from Mitchell. No. Escandor with the rebound. Sean O'Malley has stayed in the backcourt. Avellona is fouled. O'Malley is going straight to the locker room here. Has to be replaced by Ira Batalier. Three-pointer earlier from Yves Sazon for our Buenas, lucky fan of the game. Avellona. Jumper from Pao. There's a foul again on Robbie Darang.
And this is something we mentioned at the first part of the coverage. Yung matchups ni Avellona kay Robbie Darang. At yun, nakita na ng coaching staff. Papalitan si Robbie Darang dahil si Pao Avellona, as good as he is of distributing the basketball, especially in the last game, he's a guy who has the ability to score as well. Ayun. He's taking advantage of that. Kaya ang ganda ng scoring output niya so far sa larong ito.
Got 8 points in the ball game. Pao Avellona to go with 4 assists. Make that 9. 43 to 34. John Formento. That's a travel.
Walk, yeah.
He took an extra step. Sazon will return for John Formento. Don't see a lot of James Castro lately.
For Bataan. Now they're gonna go to CBC on the high-low. Right here.
Natapik ni Aquino. Shot clock winding down. Avellona doesn't know.
He does.
There's a foul away from the ball.
Double foul.
Oh. Really had no choice but to throw it up. Dalawa sila ni... The double foul possession arrow papunta sa
Bataan.
Bataan. And Manila sues for time. 3:14 remaining in the first half. Back inside the Paco Arena in Manila. As Bataan will have possession after the double foul. Sa kanila yung possession arrow. 3:14 remaining in the first half. Oh, Manila rather will have possession. Here's Mario Brian Cruz. Took an extra step. That's a travel. Offensive foul, rather. Patatlo na yan for Carl Brian Cruz.
In the next 3 minutes for Bataan, as they've been trailing this whole first half, is going to be huge heading into the second half, because two things can happen. It's either Manila can extend this lead, you know, maybe to 15, or they could trim it down and make it a ball game papasok ng third quarter.
Dorado bring us bobbled that basketball. Oh, Dante Baguio rises above everyone for the putback.
That's why you never give up on the play, even if it seems like an easy layup for your teammates. Terrific effort for the stick back.
Avilona jumper over Dorado. He's got 11 points in the ballgame.
And that's because he's bigger than the guards of Bataan. They give up about 4 or 5 inches easily. Ayan, 4 or 5 inches off the floor din yun, easily. Para sa layup ni Bringas, sa baseline drive niya na libreng-libre. Pati siya natawa.
Oh, nice fake, no help. Mitchell, jumper, wala. Rebound, Bringas. Dorado. Gets it to Sazon. Sazon fade away. No, rebound ni Escandor. 2 minute mark ng ating second quarter. Mitchell.
Escandor is open.
Escandor for three. That's another miss. Opportunity for Bataan. Dorado short on the layup. Chance on the break for Manila. But they'll pull back. Rabah Al-Husseini. Mitchell will fire. Voila. And Baguio has the rebound. Dorado, they go down low to Sazon against Mitchell. Sazon lays it in for two.
I like the decision by Sazon right there on the primary break. Instead of coming off screens, which he has been off with his shot, with a jump shot, he goes to the post instead and finishes inside the paint, testing the defense of Mitchell.
14 points para kay Sazon. Avilona, nice two-man game with Patalier.
And that's something they have to clean now. Talking about the defense of Bataan, nobody had the intention to tag the roller. That's why it was an easy two-man game between Avilona and Batalier. This is as easy as it gets.
Batalier his first basket of the ball game. We have a timeout. 46 seconds remaining in the half. Crowd here at the Paco Arena with Bataan and Manila going at it.
Parang masama loob ko sabihin yung mga susunod na lalabas sa bibig. Nagpapabati.
Talaga?
Oo. Dating teammate ni Escandor
sa
Lasal, nagpapabati pa, sikat na. KQ ang initials.
Grabe naman. Kevin Campbell
watching, supportado syempre sa kanyang teammate. Ayan na, Kev.
Actually, it's our honor na batiin ka. Saan-saan ka na lang nakikita eh.
Kev, dyan ka na lang sa kung saan-saan.
Chris Torado at the line. Yung Manila so far, they've been getting what they want sa kanilang opensa dito.
But it's only a 6-point game. So, to your point, tama ka. And that's, to me, that's because of the matchup sa guards, no? With Pau Javelona, who's in double figures, had 5 assists. He's basically has been controlling the offense for Manila. The thing is, Bataan has hung in there.
Oh, and another miss from Escandor. Chance for the last shot of the half para dito sa Bataan. 47-42.
They could trim this lead down to one possession with a 3.
They went for the extra pass there, Sazon. Instead, it's Hanapi who will score. Bringas trying to beat the buzzer. No! Manila earns a 7-point lead at the break. A well-played first half.
For both teams.
For both teams, actually. The halftime score is brought to you by GameX. 49-42, lamang ang Manila.
Morante, he played very great in the preseason tournament a year ago.
Wow, that's a beautiful move by Andre Armiñon.
Armiñon making good passes in the first few possessions, and that's
Andre Armiñon showing us what he can do, driving left and finishing with his right hand.
Caballero. They blitz him, and he loses the hand of Cormia. He's off to the races. Cormia. By New Star Max, win to the max, the spin move. And the way he was able to finish in style, Jeff Cormia.
Gonna be top here if you're Bataan.
Peralta left all alone. But no, not in my house.
To the perfect low side help of that skip pass. Timed it perfectly at the apex of that jump. Boy, you gotta love that block.
Mitchell minus.
Ooh. Chop step, the score. Crucial basket right there for Bataan.
Take a look at this, coach.
Yeah, little jab step going right. Dribble going middle, spin the other way. Leaving that defense hanging and that strong finish. And here comes Garcia. So now there are two Garcias in this lineup of Pampanga, but a steal. Villoria, the feed, and Aldai with a finish. Wow, that was tough. Oo. Squeeze niya yung sarili niya doon sa middle nung finish. Eh, kaya medyo mas mas mahirap pa rin talaga.
And he really finishes well with his left hand.
Oo.
Milk this one. Hubert Kani. Tied at 84. Kani. The step back jumper is good. Hubert Kani stepping up big time here in the overtime period. That's the biggest shot of the ball game. 6.8 seconds remaining. Negros needing a hero. And Hubert Kani with that fadeaway.
Sa excitement ng laro na to at 11 p.m. meron tayong baby na tumatalon.
Andre Arminion. Two-man game. Katakutan. He fires. That's a three-pointer. And we are all tied.
Got the ball on the left wing. Just a little jab step to throw the defense off. And then swishes it through from the outside. Big-time shot for Orin Katakutan. We're going down the wire here.
That's the first three-pointer of Val City in the second half. They're 1 out of 5. 9 on the shot clock. Off of the switch. Manalang dancing, kicking that ball out. Jello Rozon, 4 on the shot clock. Jello still has it. He leans in and scores. What a big time shot by Jello Rozon.
Yung concentration ni Jello, even the shot clock is really winding down. Waited for the right time to attack, create, and make that basket.
There's a reason why we call him Mr. Clutch for the Paranaque Patriots. He's been doing this since the 5th season of the MPBL. Dito squad of Paranaque, later on, they will be cheering against Manila. Nice feed, Kevin Santos with a throwdown! There's that pass onto Kevin Santos for his first dunk in the MPBL's 6th season. The first of many, as we should say.
And that's with authority, Mix.
He did mention, it's so easy when you have Jeff Yernes, MJ Garcia, Archie Concepcion, and Enzo Serrano all creating for you.
Misses of Ives Sasso. This being saved by the offensive rebounds of his teammates. And the putback, too.
Tara. Shot block, read 6. Robbie.
Oh, wow.
Double cross. Jumper is all nylon for Robbie Tara. 71-66. Playground basketball at its finest. The former Diliman College Blue Dragon dazzling and razzling.
And the reigning MVP of the UCAL. We talked about Robbie being underutilized in the second quarter. Man, they come back with the third, and this is really good Robbie Darang with you right now.
Halftime dito sa Paco Arena, Manila SB, Batang Sampaloc SGA with a 7-point lead against the Bataan Risers. And Manila getting the advantage in 3-point shooting and free throws. But Bataan, may response sila lagi dito, Coach Christian. And that has set the stage for what should be a really good second half.
Well, tama yan, no? And the response of Bataan, they hung in there. It felt like Manila was set to be opening this game up to like 15, 17 points. But Bataan had some crucial stops, especially midway. Pero yung mga huling part, especially yung mga ball screen situations sa Manila, tulad nung nakita nyo sa replay. Yeah, that's something that I expect they would have an adjustment on. Kung sino yung magiging tag, ano yung magiging coverage sila. And obviously the matchup, as we kept on mentioning in the first half, against Pau Havilona, who basically controlled the game, double figures, 11 points, and had 5 assists. And the bench, we talked about Bataan, the depth, right? The bench of Bataan, non-existent so far. Rafi Octubre, who led all scorers in the last game, coming off the bench, only 2 points nung first half. Sa kabila naman, Didat Hanapi coming off the bench, double figures na 10 points. Kaya ang Manila, lamang pa ngayon, 7 points.
Well, James Castro will start the third. He's been the main man for Bataan in previous seasons, but he has only averaged 12 minutes per contest, Coach Christian, the first 2 games. So, nakakapanibago. And here he is, starting the third. Castro gets it back. And that is a foul on Mitchell.
And this is an interesting decision to start the third, obviously to get James Castro going. To start him over Ives Sazon, number one, and to go to him at the first play. Obviously, yun yung intention ngayon, as a free throw siya. You know, as a scorer like James is, pag nakita mo na nasuot yung bola tulad ng unang free throw niya, maybe that could get him going. But that concern also of Ives Sazon, who finished with 14 points in that first half to lead all scorers for Bataan. Let's hope na hindi siya manlamig, no? Dahil hindi siya nag-start nitong third quarter. Because he started out this game as a part of that starting unit.
Sean O'Malley against Bringas. Ito na yung match-up na hinihintay ko. Dorado, the runner off the glass and in. Great start here for the Risers in the third.
Usually left-handed players are strong to their left. Not that time for Torado. Strong right-hand try, but finished still with his left using the glass.
That's a steal for Bringas. And trying to find Castro on the run. And he apologizes to the bench.
Go ahead.
Okay na.
What an impressive steal, I was about to say, by Bringas, right there on the denials on the post.
49-46, under 9 minutes here in the third.
Ang sinasabi ng mga pila, my bad.
It's okay. A rebound, contested, it will stay with Manila. 14 seconds on the shot. To shoot. Navarro gets it to Cruz for three. No. Baguio with the rebound. Now with Torado. Torado in trouble. Labas. Ooh. Masyado malakas yung pasa. So back-to-back turnovers for Bataan. Just when it seemed like they were making a run.
And as we said of James Castro of starting this third quarter, interesting decision also for Manila not to start Pau Havilona.
Well, we have Navarro here. Cruz is open.
That's
yes.
Money. Yeah, his game here in our league with his length and his ability to score inside and out, perfect. Uh-huh. For the NPBL.
Absolutely. Bring us against O'Malley. O'Malley
Ayun na yung banggang inaabangan mo between Bringas and Umali, pero sasahig lang nangyari.
May collateral damage mo si Cristo.
How about that? Both guys, Bringas diving on the floor. Umali ending up on the floor.
Tignan natin yung nangyari dito.
Pulling the chair and tapping the ball from behind.
Doon yung foul.
Ayun. Oo, foul naman talaga. It's good to see Umali not getting hurt on that play.
They're gonna challenge the foul.
I don't think they will win it. Because to me, that's clearly a foul.
So 51 to 46. So as we wait for this challenge, let's give a quick shout out kay Mayor Berhel Meneses of Bulacan.
Idol.
The aerial voyager.
Idol. How I'm thankful to God na hindi ko inabot yung taong yan.
Yung miss ko na si coach. Tagal ko nang hindi nakita. Okay, so we have a confirmation from our crew chief, Jojo Belnas, a successful challenge.
How about the improvement? No, I'm not... From what I remember last year of doing a few games, I don't remember in the past few seasons na lumalapit yung referee sa atin to let us know about the result of the challenge. I think that's because of you. Takot sa'yo.
Hindi naman. Grabe ka naman. Eh sa NBA nga, yung referee nagsasabi ng decision eh. Sila pa nag-i-explain. Ito yung contact dito.
Clearly a foul. Clearly a foul.
Because... Umali would have gotten completed the steal if hindi siya na trip dun. So we're back to live action here.
Watch out for that short corner underneath. Umali against this zone. 1-3-1 zone. Good pass.
Hanapi is open. Yes, sir.
And that's the reason why Navarro starts the third quarter, because he also has the ability to look for, create and look for open guys. 3-on-1.
Hindi niya nakita. Escandor. Umali. We'll wait for Navarro. Cruz. They go down low to Umali. Navarro. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Renzo. Flips it up. No. Sean O'Malley with a putback. 4 points now para kay Sean O'Malley. And it's a 10-point lead para sa Manila. A 7-0 run after the 4-0 run to start the third. Pambataan. Baguio fires. No. Cruz.
Excellent box out by Navarro.
Oh, nice pass. Oh, the block!
By Baguio on Escandor.
Castro, Totorado. Oh! Cruz says no.
Back-to-back blocks by both teams on layups. The first by Baguio on Escandor. And CBC on Dorado. Palitan na ng tao.
Latalier in. Just watch this block. Baguio sticks it in. Dorado. No. Hanapi. Bigay agad kay Navarro. 4 blocks for Manila. Only 1 for Bataan. That was the first one earlier. Latalier.
There's the short corner. There you go.
Carl Brian Cruz. Easy two.
But that 2-3 zone, especially on the reversal, that short corner is always going to be open. And if you attract the defense, that dive from the mid-post is going to be open. And that's what happened on the last play.
Castro forcing the issue, draws the foul. by Wes Sazon, all set to return. I'm going to say Mitchell Minus. John Hamon also returns. Sama si Raba Luseni. And DiPaggio gets a breather, so I think ibabalik si Wes Sazon for James Castro. Gets his third point of the ball game. Free throw is brought to you by Extreme. Ang subok at kompletong appliance brand ng Pilipinas. Split at the line para kay James Castro. Batalier. Binigay kay Renzo Navarro. Alusaini trying to get in position. Shot clock down to 6.
Walk.
Travel.
Navarro had the right idea, but a little disconnected was the offense, especially Navarro and his bigs. Batalier was looking for the high-low to Raba Alusaini. But then Navarro wanted a handoff. Then he went for the drive to use Alusaini as a screener. Nawala nga lang yung bola. Ended up as a turnover.
11-point lead for Manila. Here's Sazon. Swings it over. Octubre.
He needs this shot.
Rafi Octubre. Could be the start of something good para sa kanya.
Well, that's big both for Bataan and for him, because he's important to this team. They need his production to give this team a chance every game.
58-50. Robbie Darang is back in the ball game. Darang drives. Short. Yes, last touch on Alex Ramos. Rafi Octubre. Binalik na si Pau Habilona dito. Rekindling this matchup with Robbie Darang. Batalier ang nagbababa ng bola. Hamon. Hamon fires a 3. Yes, sir! 5 points para kay John Hamon.
Escandor sits down. Hamon comes in. Both a threat from the outside. And anytime you have post players like Raba Alusaini, who's being doubled since the start of the first half, it's going to open up the game of the shooters like Hamon and Escandor.
The lucky fan of the game is brought to you by Buena. Hamon.
He checked.
He was feeling it. Batalier fouls Darang. Stopping the break. Just the third team foul for Manila here sa ating third quarter. Darang. Step back 3. In and out. Batalier nakuha yung rebound. Bigay kay Paolo Habilona.
Good in, pass.
Inside they go. Alusaini.
That's a walk.
Nakakuha pa siya ng foul kay Alex Ramos.
I know. Nonetheless, he ends up at the line.
Raba Alusaini.
What a beautiful pass from the backcourt.
And they cleared,
the entry pass.
They cleared the middle.
Well, that's because of the shooters that Manila has.
Oh.
Because instead of the defenders clogging in to Manila's big men and how they have shot the ball, especially that 3 but by Hamon in the previous play, it's going to open up eventually the inside game.
63-50. Bringas able to recover the loose ball. Harvey forces that one in. And the foul is whistled against Batalier.
A little adjustment on the ball screen now. The hard show by Manila opens up the quick roll to RV Bringas. ends up at the free throw line.
Medyo matulis yung unang free throw ni RV Bringas. 2 points, 4 rebounds.
Well, let's see kung magpapatuloy no yung ball screen defensive coverage ng Manila, especially if you have Octubre as the second feeder para sa Bataan, because he would end up open kung walang magre-recover ng maayos. Hamon, challenged by Octubre.
Batalier puts it in. 4 points para kay Batalier. Lead is extended to 14. Maynez will go to the line.
Bilis ng atake, no? Off a main basket. The quick inbound forward pass. Maynez will end up at the line. Little push from behind by Raba. No call. But Batalier right there with that one-handed kiss off the glass.
Ito sa unang free throw ni Mitchell Maynez.
As you see, the head coach of Bataan.
Sir Rudy Ilaga. Kasama niya, of course, si Coach Rene. So 1-for-2 para kay Mitchell Maynez, 65-52.
13 points for Mitchell Maynez. Was in double figures already in the first half with 12. He's gotten a little cold here. Only his first point of the quarter.
Batalier goes back. That's the foul there.
Sazon, after scoring 14 points and not starting the third quarter, down by 7 at the half. Now it's doubled to 14. He just came in a few minutes ago. Let's see if he can get his rhythm.
6 points para kay Batalier. Robbie Darang, they get the switch. Octubre against Abilona. Rafi, lumapit. No. Ang tapik, makukuha ni Pau Abilona. Quick into Hamon. They go to Aluseni. Against Octubre. Raba. Quick spin to the baseline and he draws the foul.
But it all started on the defensive end. We mentioned earlier in if it's Bringas giving the ball screen, it's the hard show. But that time, Octubre with the ball screen, they switch it because in respect to, you know, his ability to pop out and shoot the basketball and trusting the individual defense of Paulo Havelona, making etong si Octubre do something he's not accustomed to, which is putting the ball on the floor. They get the stop and they end up at the line with Raba Aluseni.
Still perfect at the line, Raba Aluseni. Balik si Jamil Gabawan sa laro for Rafi Octubre. 69-52. Under 3 minutes remaining sa ating third quarter. Manila outscoring Bataan 20-10 in this quarter. Robbie Darang.
Single-double floppy play for Bataan. Well defended by Manila. There's the hard show as Bringas gives the screen.
Bringas against Batalier. Harvey, wala. Gabawan to Maynez, banks it in.
6 points for Gabawan.
Abilona. No.
Tulak. Natawa na lang si Paolo.
Nasa penalty na ang Bataan, so that will mean 2 free throws.
This is how smart of a player Paolo is. 3 times, he used the screen. Twice a re-screen. Bakit? Kasi yung unang dalawa nag-under. And on the third try on the re-screen, Ayun yung tulak ni Gabawan, a little nudge from behind. Good acting job by Pau.
Artistahin talaga to si, ano?
Oo, eh.
Si Pau, eh.
But what really put him in that position was the last screen. Dahil lumalalim na yung screen, napilitan na si Darang umibabaw.
Pau Havilona. Tahimik siya dito sa ating third quarter. Hindi niya sinimulan ang quarter na to.
Hindi rin kasi siya nagsimula ng third quarter. And an excellent job by Navarro, who started the third. He saw that drive and hook pass for Hanapi three. He controlled that pace.
What a luxury for Manila. No?
Right, and able to create a double-digit lead after leading by 7 at the half.
They've combined for 13 assists in the long guardia ng Manila. Darang gets the finger roll to drop.
And they combined for 14 in the last game, 14 of the 25. So they are on track of surpassing that. Robbie Darang scores for Bataan. High-low play.
O'Malley with a reverse.
Kanina pa hinahanap ng Manila yan. Yung high-low connection ng kanilang bigs. Finally, they succeed. Here, late in the third quarter.
Gabawan.
Ayun, high-low din.
Bring us, well defended by Raba.
Look at Raba sprint down.
Raba gets the ball down low. O'Malley will take the three. That won't go. Robbie Darang pulls up. No good on the jumper.
They're going to go to the post. And let's see if Bataan will still double. They've been doubling Al-Husseini in the first half. There's that face-up.
That's short. Minus. Ooh. Minus gets that one to drop.
That's an offensive foul. This is a good call. Oh, my.
Not an offensive foul.
It's not an offensive foul. Probably because Hamon was not in legal position or was not set for it.
Yeah, he was moving.
He was moving. There you go. As a former player, these are the type of plays that I truly hate. Yung ikaw na inasaktan, ikaw pa ang foul.
Ganun talaga yung ano, buhay minsan.
Parang love life lang din.
You take the hit sometimes.
Okay, Sylvester Stallone.
Wow.
Okay, Rocky.
Wow. Mitchell is back in the game. It's a smile si Ate Mika na sa atin eh.
Here four come, on one.
Here comes Bataan. The extra pass to Castro.
Bataan just continues to hang in there. That's clearly a foul. There has to be a technical here somewhere. Somebody has to get a technical.
Pau Havilona in the middle of it.
Because I think Havilona has all the right to be upset. But dahil feeling niya na foul niya siya nung first eh. But I see James Castro appealing to the official na Havilona was trying to hook his arm. Dahil alam ni Havilona nasa penalty na both teams.
Yeah.
But I gotta see the replay once again. One thing's for sure, merong may mate-technical dito. Anspo.
Foul on Castro. Senyos. Nakita natin may foul na kay Castro.
Foul number 39, Jamil Gabawan.
Oh, Jamil Gabawan.
His second.
So Jamil Gabawan.
I didn't know he was even in the play.
Nandun siya.
Nandun siya, okay.
Ito.
Ito. Ayun yung sinasabi ni Castro, yung hook.
There's the foul there.
There's the foul. May pito na kasi even before that. Tapos ito, tinapigal ni Gabawan. Piling ko hindi nila narinig yung pito eh. Kaya...
Parang ano eh.
Wala naman eh.
There's the foul right there.
This could be a good thing though for Bataan.
Just fire them up.
Because they certainly have the personnel to fire the other team up in a negative way. Let's see how Manila responds. May mga veterano na rin dyan.
2 for 2.
James Tempra in the game.
Yeah.
Former FBU Tamara. For the first time. Sa larong ito.
74 to 61. Castro against Mitchell. Octubre ready to provide the pick.
There's the switch on Octubre.
Gabawan. That's a tough shot. Batalier with the rebound. And that will do it for the third quarter. Manila able to increase their lead in the third period. 74 to 61. End of the third quarter score is brought to you by GameX. Presenting our Suzuki Muscular and Sporty fan of the game, just like the Avenis. Do more and achieve more with the Muscular and Sporty scooter from Suzuki. The Avenis. Oras na para magmotor. Manila with a 13-point lead going into the last 10 minutes of this ball game. And they will start with Escandor, Batalier, Carl Brian Cruz, Avilona, and Mitchell.
I like the adjustment that Manila made in that third quarter. They did not wait for Octubre after hitting his first shot to make more damage. Switching on ball screens, kaya nalimitado kagad. You see the quarter scoring, Manila winning that third quarter, 25 to 19, creating separation. Doon sa third quarter, kaya lumamang sila into double figures. Beautiful baseline screen action between Castro and Gabawan. Gabawan, easy layup at the rim.
And they put Jeff Santos on Pau Habilona, a much taller player. Cruz knocks it down.
That's big. That's big. I know it's only the second possession of this quarter, pero medyo pamatay sunog yun.
Castro drives baseline. He stepped on the line.
And that's how big the shot of Carl Brian Cruz was. Especially if they score on this one to continue to extend their lead, maybe to 15 or 16.
Foot on the line, Carl Brian Cruz.
Foot on the line, hand in his face, all net though.
Batalier to Mitchell. Nice two-man action here. Batalier denied. Santos leading the break here. Gives it up to Castro for three. Short. The foul of James Castro. No sign of Ibestazo.
No, I was about to say. Both the two leading scorers in the first half, which was Minus and Ives Sazon in minus with 14 and 12 respectively in the first half. Has gone cold here in the second half.
Mitchell.
There's the switch. Good pass.
Gabawan thought he had a steal.
Dito mo makikita yung experience na sinasabi. Sometimes that word is overused. The first action of the ball screen, they were squeezing CBC, especially of his ability to make the shot. But on the second action, they switched. And si CBC, instead of popping out, he rolled to the basket, realizing the switch and the mismatch, created the foul.
Enzo Navarro is back in the game. CBC. That's a turnover. Did not expect the pass.
It was actually good intention, bad execution. Because if that pass was executed well, that could have been an open shot for CBC.
October.
Wow, interesting matchup. October. Umali on October.
Santos for three.
What a rebound.
Mitchell plucks it out of the air. Mitchell. Three in the key. Back-to-back turnovers for Manila.
Coach Gabby telling Mitchell should have gone all the way after the breakdown move.
Octubre. They go to Gabawan against Cruz.
Offensive foul.
Rafi Octubre is...
was called for an offensive foul. Now they're checking if there was an extension of the arms, maybe to upgrade the foul. Chinecheck nilo. Well, you don't see it on your screens, but two officials. It's a replay table.
Yeah.
The special replay table.
It looks like that will be ito na, replay tayo.
Offensive foul lang, regular foul.
Oh, because the forearm was out, hindi nakadikit sa katawan.
Yun. Ayun. So the point na talagang humiga ito si Mitchell sa sahig.
So they're asking for a delay of game.
Totoo naman kasi.
You know what? Timeout. Review lang yun.
Pero everybody does that. Medyo nag-extend lang ng konti ang bataan. Elevator play.
Escandor. Cruz. They go down low to O'Malley. Sean. No. Rebound. Collected by Mitchell. Fires a three. That's good. 5 points para kay DJ Mitchell. And these are some timely hits from Cruz earlier and now Mitchell.
He's been struggling all throughout the game. Scored in double figures in their last game. Maybe that could get him going. That's a foul. That's a foul. And they're going to check if this would qualify as an unsportsmanlike foul because we saw that in the first game. Automatically, natawagan yung unsportsmanlike foul sa landing spot against Michael Mabula.
Three-point shot is brought to you by Extreme One-Stop Shop Appliances.
Ay, de, chinek lang nila kung nasa three-point line.
The first foul on Sean O'Malley, so... But the free throw para kay Robbie Darang. misses the first.
Bataan has been decent from the line before that miss. Now 13 for 18.
Robbie Darang, 6 points and 3 rebounds. The lead is at 14, 6.5 minutes remaining. Escandor will fire. He's still struggling. Darang. Santos, 3-pointer, wala.
That could have been big for Bataan. Still a 14-point lead. Navarro tells his troops not to rush.
O'Malley lost the handle. Here comes Sazon. Gives it to Darang. Robbie Darang, basket and one.
And what a beautiful lead. 3-on-2 break by Yves Sazon.
They're looking to challenge this one.
For the offensive foul on Durang, maybe. Di natin nakita rito eh. Yung angulo natin medyo nakatakip.
Oo. It's officially a challenge here from Coach Gabby. So the whistle on the floor is a foul on Francis Escandor.
I like the light, huh? The yellow light right in front of our barker, Richard Tampos. Parang anghel yung dating eh. Pakita nyo nga direct para alam ni Mr. Tupas kung anong ibig sabihin. Habang naka-coaches challenge.
It's Charles Chu on your screens as well. Helping out this Manila team. Okay. Kumbaga, sa balita, nauna tayo.
Nauna tayo. Yeah.
Kumbaga, breaking news.
Yan.
Ipo-post pa lang, alam na natin.
Yeah.
Yun ang, so, unsuccessful yung tali.
Kahit kailan, chismoso ko talaga.
That's the business, you know? Ano lang tayo? Stick to facts lang tayo.
Yan.
Sinabi naman ng...
The challenge made by Manila was unsuccessful.
This is big for...
It is. For Bataan.
Yeah.
Look at the fast break. Yves Sazon, which usually goes all the way, nabasa na yung intention of trying to draw the charge was Navarro. Iniwasan yung charge, makes the right pass, and Robbie Darang right there finishes. 2+1 coming up.
Hindi pa vertical si Escandor. Palayo pa siya eh. No? He was moving left to right while challenging the shot. Can the Risers come up with one more run here?
5 straight points for Darang, a total of 9. A lot of time to make maybe 2 runs for Bataan to come back into this ball game. 11-point lead.
Cruz.
There's that high-low once again. Well defended individually by Gabawan.
O'Malley. Spin move. That is off. Sean O'Malley is asking for a foul.
Yeah, this is why it's so important for big men, especially going to their right shoulder, to learn how to finish with that offhand.
Oh, Sazon, quick release. That's good. And the lead of Manila is down to 8.
8 straight points and an offensive foul. Excellent defense on that ball screen by Darang on the ball. 8-0 run by Bataan, and they will get the basketball. Al-Husseini coming in for more post-presence threat probably for Manila.
Sazon. They're asking for a travel, the entire Manila bench.
Yun lang.
It's a turnover.
Yun lang. Bigat ng turnover na yun.
Well defended by Ivesazo.
It was. I thought they were fortunate that it ended up as a dead ball turnover, because kung na-save ni Sazon yun, that would have been a fast break on the other end, a live turnover. Amon coming in.
Navarro against Narang. 14 turnovers for Manila, 3 more than Bataan. Navarro.
Hanapi's gonna be open. Oh.
Alusaini. Another great pass galing kay Renzo Navarro.
Masyadong maaga bumitaw yung tagger, kaya nalibre si Alusaini. They were so worried about the shooters. Hanapi, 13 points. Dalawa na ang tres niyan. Hamon has made a 3. Screen and roll. Little tag right there. Pero si Sazon yung bumitaw.
Oh, lumayo eh. Play of the game is brought to you by Buenas.
He was worried because Hanapi relocated at the top of the key. Open shot though for Sazon.
81-74. Sazon up to 20 points in the ball game. And a foul whistled on Robbie Darang.
And a beautiful play of the inbounds. Out of bounds under by Bataan. Fourteen foul, which puts them over the limit on the next one. Free throws na yan para sa Manila.
And what about this play?
Ganda.
Libre si Ives Sazon. That foul whistled on Robbie Darang.
Gabawan, an underrated screen setter. San Juan days pa yan eh.
That's true. Navarro. Hamon, quick trigger. Wala.
Tough shot.
Rebound ni Mitchell Maynes. The Risers.
What a move!
Natakam siya.
Ang ganda na nung galaw eh, nawala lang yung bola.
Oo nga.
And that was a wide open lane for Maynes. Again, on that mini in-out move. Eh, napikean niya daw. Nawala lang, di lang niya mag-gather yung bola.
May tapik galing kay Navarro eh.
Pero tumama rin sa tuhod. So good recovery by Navarro.
Navarro, three-pointer. Nawala. Agawan sa rebound. Ends up with Didat Hanapi.
Not a fan of that shot by Navarro, even though it was a good move.
So no call. Hanapi. No call as well. Darang. Looking for Sazon for 3. Yes, sir! 23 points para kay Ives Sazon. He's come alive here in the fourth.
And this Bataan crowd who traveled from Bataan here in Manila is alive once again.
Hanapi got the step. Alusaini free. Wala. Hanapi with the rebound. Layup is good. 15 points para kay Didat Hanapi.
And that's the price you pay when you have a small lineup with Maynes and Octubre in your front court. Giving up offensive rebounds even to a guy like Hanapi. But a foul here by Navarro. A good job of breaking down the defense with that two-man game. Ives Sazon right here with the hot hand. Nothing but bottom.
And kita pagbaba ni Besazo, hinahawakan niya yung kamay niya. Nagliliyap daw. But on the other end, Didat Hanapi gets the layup to drop. So John Hamon and Batalier. So lineup here for Manila. Cruz, Hanapi, Alusaini, and the two point guards, Navarro and Javilona.
Well, this is the perfect time for Manila to really go to that high-low play with Octubre manning the middle for them. He's guarding Alusaini and punish this small lineup of Bataan, because it has worked for Bataan so far that has allowed them to get back in this game.
So Mitchell Maynes gets a breather. Pinasok si Ron Lastimosa kasama si Rafi Octubre, Ives Sazon, Jeff Santos, and Robbie Darang.
Small lineup pa rin. Ives Sazon guarding CBC.
Avilona finds Aluseni.
And that's what we talked about. That's why Avilona, the veteran that he is, reading the defense of how, you know, Bataan has covered the outside shooters. It's going to open up guys like Aluseni.
5-point lead for Manila.
13 points off the bench for Rabah Aluseni, who has yet to miss from the free throw line. He's going to make this one, or not. I was trying not to jinx myself. I'm sorry.
Lastimosa, good line. Wala. Ang tapik napunta kay Ives Sazon. To Octubre for three. No. Navarro with the rebound.
Could have been big. But it's been a while since Rafi Octubre has seen a clear path of the rim.
Hanapin. Aluseni. Against Octubre. Rabah. Well defended by Octubre. Darang. Challenges the D of Cruz.
A good aggressive move by Darang, but I thought he had Octubre on the trail in the middle. They could have gotten an easy two right there. Fortunate that they will still retain possession. There's Octubre in the middle.
Oh.
But a good block nonetheless by CBC.
Last 2 minutes brought to you by GameX.
That is just unforced.
Oh.
Unforced turnover. That would put Aluseni in a mismatch speed-wise against Octubre, but they lose the ball on the inbound. They're going to look for that high-low on Aluseni.
Rabah. Yes.
And guess what? They make them pay.
15 points para kay Rabah Aluseni. Sazon gets it to Octubre. 7-point lead for Manila.
They're switching this one.
Darang for three.
Excellent defense by Manila. Excellent challenge by CBC to force Darang into that contested shot. Basket timeout situation for Bataan.
Another whistle. To 79, 69 seconds remaining. There's a whistle away from the ball, and that's an unsportsmanlike foul.
Sa ulo kasi, above the shoulder, no? Unnecessary na.
Foul on number 21, Rabah Aluseni. That's his first.
Rabah Aluseni. Check out the replay here. Yun, yung kaliwang siko na tumama kay Rafi Octubre. So,
mabigat yun. Mabigat yun. Free throws plus ball possession. 7-point lead. Pwede maging single possession while the clock is not moving.
Yeah, they can get two points and then could be a 5-point possession here for Bataan. Big development here. Octubre. Yes. So, bola pa ng Bataan and they can make it a one possession game here.
Shot clock 14 seconds.
They mentioned about yung resilience nitong Bataan team. Both teams with a couple of timeouts left. Pareho nasa penalty. Darang.
Watch out for Sazon.
Darang pulls up. Jumper, that's short. Agawan sa rebound. Ends up with Pau Habilona.
I'm not so sure if that's the shot they want. Especially with the hot hand that Ives Sazon has in this game, in this quarter.
Enzo Navarro. Manila looking to put the finishing touches here. Navarro. Avellona is open. He fires and hits. Pau Avellona. A big shot. He's at 17 points in the ball game, and he extends Manila's lead to 8.
Now what a beautiful play of what could be the dagger. Bataan called defense. Avellona calls game. Big three to extend the lead to 8. And it just might be enough to put this team away.
Pau Habilona with the big shot, but you know, some big decisions down the stretch spelling the difference here, Coach Christian.
Now, what a big time play by Manila. We saw a contested shot on the other end for Bataan that they missed while creating an advantage to an open shot for Manila. Sazon misses, offensive rebound for Bataan.
Octubre, wala. Minus is fouled by Batalier. Penalty 89-81. We're gonna check if there should be another call here.
So can you make, you can make two calls, though.
Oo. Kasi baka may
excessive
force yung next ano eh.
Upgraded.
Robby Darang. Could be a Manila just not allowing Bataan to get the looks that they needed here down the stretch. And also, you know, Bataan din eh. Some decisions that you thought, you know, some plays na gusto mo sana na you would have liked Ives Sazon to take the shots. But kanina, Robby Darang took it in by himself. Pero it is what it is now for Bataan.
It's not only that. It's obviously looking for the hot hand, but at the same time, getting the best shot available, regardless of who it is. And that's the difference. Yung deciding factor ng laro, you can make an argument, it was two possessions. One contested shot, one uncontested shot by Darang and Avellona. And you could say also that play by Aluseni could have been costly for them. Because how many times have we seen late in the ball game with a foul like that and the tides would turn to the other team, right? So it's always a learning experience for both teams playing win or lose. And that's something the coaches would address for sure.
Yeah, that's for sure. And Mintis sa pangalawang free throw ni Mitchell Maynes, who's into, has now 19 points in the ball game. Big game from him as well.
Yeah, I thought what's big for Manila, at least compared, especially in their last game against a weaker, I think it's safe to say, a weaker team in Bulacan, because siempre loaded tong Manila, is they got a taste of their potential. Itong game na to, because it was a real test. You know, going up against an undefeated team in Bataan, 2-0. But at the same time, Hanapi, double figures, 13 points. He had some, big shots in the first half that allowed them to create cushion. Al Husseini established himself inside, got to the line a ton of times. Javelona and Navarro, the consistent play of being the generals on the floor. And yet, as you mentioned at the top of the coverage, wala pang Greg Slaughter yan.
Oh. And Carl Brian Cruz.
Carl Brian Cruz was solid all throughout the game on both ends.
Oh. Fast break of the game is brought to you by New Star Max. Win to the max.
And the role players, John Hamon, for example, played 13 minutes, had 5 points. But he had a three, that extended their lead, bought some minutes for him, some rest for their key guys.
And another timeout for the one Bataan Risers, Camaya Coast. It's a 6-point lead para sa Manila. And a huge homecoming para dito sa Manila. They are 13 seconds away from clinching their second straight win. Definitely a team that's a work in progress pa, pero it's filled with veterans, with players na either may napatunayan na or may gusto pang patunayan. And may napatunayan na nga, gusto pang, getting a new lease on their careers.
Right.
Rabah Al Husseini, Carl Brian Cruz.
Right. Well, at the end of the day, whatever the personal motivation is, you got to do your job. You signed a contract, and that means you're committed of playing to the highest standard possible of the team. And that's something, that's a word that, people don't usually throw around in commitment, but once you commit to that, you're committed to playing for your team, playing for yourself, and playing to get that championship eventually.
That's true.
Or to put yourself in a position for. Because this team, make no mistake, they have championship aspirations. They should have championship aspiration.
I don't think it's a secret, because if you come up with this type of lineup,
right,
seryoso ka. Talaga.
And this is no Bataan 2-0 coming into this game. They're a playoff team. They're a playoff team, I think. But being a championship team in terms of on paper, I'm not sure if everyone would say that. But again, sample size pa lang yung nakikita natin. Two, three games for the teams.
Malayo pa tayo.
Malayo pa.
Sa October. Mahaba-haba pa to, Coach Christian. Kaya, madalas ka magpa-schedule para magkasama tayo lagi.
Calling Coach Gold. Calling Coach Gold.
Paalam ka na. Robbie Darang. Over the top.
For Bataan, on the other hand, a lot of teaching moments in this game.
It's true.
A lot of teaching moments. They will you know, watch the tape, so to speak. Kahit na wala ng tape ngayon. And we'll try to adjust and clean up what they need to clean up.
Yeah.
This is a great organization itong Bataan.
Oh, and it's well supported by both the ownership and the LGU
fans.
And the fans.
My
as
goodness.
Well. Their best player of the game is brought to you by Buenas, and he started out strong, Pau Havilona, and finished it off with a dagger three to end the hopes of the Bataan comeback. And he is our Buenas best player of the game, Pau Havilona, clutch three-pointer, 17 points, 6 rebounds, and 7 assists para kay Pau Havilona.
More than the numbers and the production, which you just saw, how they controlled the game, that tandem between him and Navarro, if they continue to play like this, this team is going to be lethal.
So our final score is brought to you by GameX, 90-84. Let's go to Mika.
Maraming salamat at kasama ko ngayon ang Buenas player of the game na si Pau Havilona. Pau, you're slowly getting the system of Coach Gabby, no? Kayong team, lalo na with a bench this deep, medyo challenging din talaga mag-set up ng plays para sa kanya.
Actually, yun lang. Kailangan lang din talaga namin maging disciplined sa laro. Offensively, defensively, kailangan namin sundin yung mga utos ng coaches kasi alam naman namin, ilalagay nila kami sa magandang posisyon para manalo.
Pero ang isang impressive ngayon pa lang yung backcourt nyo, no? Kumusta yung relationship mo at yung camaraderie mo dun sa mga mas batang guards?
Actually, sobrang okay yung teammates ko lahat. Walang nagre-reklamo. Lahat kami sumusunod. Kung kahit payuan mo man yung mga bata, sumusunod sila. Kaya yun yung maganda sa amin. Nagtutulungan kami, hindi kami nag-iwanan. Kahit lamang yung kalaban o lamang kami.
Yung mga bata daw, sabi ni Kuya Pao, meron ka ba mga gustong batihin at pasalamatan?
Una-una, binabati ko si Mayor Hani Lacuna, Congressman Sam Versosa, SGA Frank Lau, Awesome Smile, Robust, Fortune Pay, Ryan David Rojas, sa mga batang 641, Raymond D. Ang, Emilio Chu, Anytime Fitness Banawe, yung wife ko, yung family ko sa Pakulod, yung baby ko na iniwan namin, baka tulog na. Thank you.
Maraming salamat, our Buenas player of the game is Pau Havilona. Balik sa inyo sa Delft, Coach Chris.
The Pau Havilona leading the way para dito sa Manila. Our games tomorrow, we will be at the Caloocan Sports Complex. San Juan against Marikina. San Juan making their 2024 MTBL season debut. Para naman sa Paranaque Patriots, they're looking for their third win as they battle the Iloilo. So yan po yung mga laban namin bukas. So subaybayan niyo po ang Liga ng Bawat Pilipino. For my partner, Coach Christian Juanzon, courtside reporter Mika Bisamis, and for all the men and women making up the Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League, this is Delft Tupa saying goodnight from Paco, Manila.
May labay nagkakaisa, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, basketball na. Ang bawat labay pinaghahandaan, kaya yumayanig ang